Eureka, Grade 2, Module 4, Lesson 4. Add and subtract multiples of 10 and some ones within 100. Hi, I'm glad you're back. I'm excited for another math lesson with you today. Let's get started. On the screen, there are two sticks of linking cubes. The top stick has 5 linking cubes. The bottom stick also has 5 linking cubes. If I add a few more linking cubes to the bottom stick, how many linking cubes are there in the bottom stick? That's right, there are now 8 linking cubes in the bottom stick. What is the difference between 8 and 5? Or the difference between the bottom row and the top row? That's right, 3. A math equation to match this would be 8 subtract 5 equals 3. The difference between 8 and 5 is 3. It's represented here with our 3 red linking cubes. What would happen if I add 2 green linking cubes, one to the top row and one to the bottom row? Does it change the difference between the two rows? Look closely. It doesn't. I still have a difference of 3. However, it does change the math equation. I now have 9 linking cubes on the bottom row and 6 linking cubes on the top, but the difference is still 3. Let's take a look at this using tape diagrams. Here at the top, we have a tape diagram drawn to show 8 and 5. Remember, we were trying to find the difference between 8 and 5 and realized it was 3. I added 1 green linking cube to the end of each of our linking cube sticks. Here on our tape diagram, I've added 1 to both 8 and 1 to 5. While it did change the total number of linking cubes, it did not change the difference. 8 subtract 5 equals 9 subtract 6. They're equal or equivalent, and the difference does not change. When we add the same amount to each number in a subtraction sentence, the difference stays the same. That's an amazing thought. Let's take a look at a more challenging subtraction equation. This one might be a little too challenging for me. What about this one? Yeah, we can answer that one pretty quickly, can't we? 36 subtract 30. We know we just take away 3 tens, and we're left with 6 ones. Let's take a look at 34 subtract 28 using a tape diagram. I drew 34 on the top and 28 on the bottom. We're trying to find the difference. Remember, the difference is what we get when we subtract 28 from 34. Let's look closely at this. What would happen if I added 2 to the end of each of these numbers? I added 2 because I knew 28 needed 2 more to make 30, and it's much easier to add and subtract when we're just working with tens. So I'm going to find the next closest 10, which is 30. But if I add 2 to 28 to get 30, I also need to add 2 to 34. Now I have 36 and 30. That's much easier to subtract. So 34 subtract 28 is equal to 36 subtract 30. And we know 36 subtract 30 is 6. So 34 subtract 28 is 6. Wow, that made it a lot easier to solve that subtraction problem. Remember, when we add the same amount to each number in a subtraction sentence, the difference stays the same. So I could add 2 to both sides and still get the same answer. It just made it easier for me because I made the next unit or the next 10. Take a look at the linking cubes in this picture. I have 6 on the left-hand side of the yellow cube and 4 on the right-hand side of the yellow cube. With 6 and 4 and 1 yellow cube, how many do I have total? If you said 11, that's right. I have 11 linking cubes. I'm going to split it right here. Let's write an addition sentence that will match the picture. 6 red linking cubes on the left plus 5 linking cubes on the right equals 11. What if I split it a different way and slide the yellow linking cube over to the left? Now what will my number sentence look like? Now I have 7 on the left and 4 on the right. Together, 7 plus 4 equals 11. That means 6 plus 5 is equal to 7 plus 4. They're the same. It didn't matter which way I slid that yellow linking cube, I still had 11 linking cubes. Let's take a look at a tape diagram. At the top, you can see 6 with 1 and 4, which equals 5. On the bottom, you can see 6 with 1, which was 7, and 4. Regardless of which way we slid that yellow linking cube, we still had the sum of 11. So 6 plus 5 equals 7 plus 4. They were both 11. Let's see if we can use this idea or this concept to help us solve a more challenging addition sentence. 28 plus 36. Let's do it with tape diagrams. Here's 28. How many more do I need to add to 28 to get to the next 10? Remember, using tens to add and subtract helps us. It makes it more simple and easier for us to solve. How many more do I need to add to 28 to get to the next 10, which is 30? 2. That's what I need. So I'm going to add another piece of my tape diagram labeled 2. That's what I need to get to 30. Now, I need to finish this tape diagram, but I have to take away 2 from 36. Remember, I was sliding it over to make 30, so I need to remove it from 36. What is 2 less than 36? If you said 34, you got it. 2 less than 36 is 34. We still have our 36. See? It's represented here with 2 and 34. And we still have 28. So we still have all the pieces of our addition equation. Let's look at this using a number bond to help us understand what we're doing. 28 plus 36. We can split 36 into 2. Here it is. And 34, right here. Remember, we needed 2 to make the next 10. 28 plus 2 equals 30. Now I have 3 tens, and I can easily add 3 tens, 30, 2, 34, and get the answer 64. That means 28 plus 36 is 64. Wow, what a helpful strategy! When we add, we can move part of one number to another to make an easier addition problem with tens, because adding groups of 10 can be much simpler than adding tens and ones. Good job today. You're going to get a chance to practice making tape diagrams to help solve equations back on Seesaw. Head back to Seesaw and I'll see you again tomorrow.